Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Mridul and I am part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. Due to the great development in IoT, we have multiple options to choose the right board for our application. In this video, we will be comparing two very popular IoT-centric development boards, the ESP32 and the Arduino Nano RP2040. ESP32 was developed by the Espressif Systems, while Arduino developed the Arduino Nano RP2040 in collaboration with Raspberry Pi. ESP32 has a 32-bit dual-core 10-silica extensa LX6 processor, having a clock speed of 160 to 240 MHz. Arduino Nano RP2040, on the other hand, also has a 32-bit dual-core processor running at 133 MHz, but it uses an ARM Cortex-M0+ architecture. ESP32 chip has inbuilt 802.11b/g/n 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi compatibility with up to 150 megabits per second and Bluetooth version 4.2 with BLE support. Arduino Nano RP2040 has an embedded Nina W102 U-Blocks module, which also provides the same wireless capabilities. Both the boards vary a lot when it comes to RAM and ROM. ESP32 has a RAM of 320 kilobytes and a ROM of only 448 kilobytes, whereas Arduino Nano RP2040 has a RAM of 264 kilobytes and a ROM of 16 megabytes. The number of I/O pins and interfaces can be a major reason for accepting or rejecting a board for a specific application. ESP32 has 32 GPIO pins consisting of 18 digital, 18 analog, and 16 PWM pins. Arduino Nano RP2040 has 22 GPIO pins consisting of 22 digital, 8 analog and 18 PWM pins. Both the boards support SPI, I2C interface and UART protocol, but only ESP32 supports the I2S interface. ESP32 has inbuilt cryptography support and Arduino Nano RP2040 has cryptographic IC embedded for the same. Arduino Nano RP2040 has embedded sensors such as a 6-axis inertial measurement unit with machine learning core for gyroscope and accelerometer, and a MEMS omnidirectional microphone IC for microphone. Arduino Nano RP2040 also has RGB LED onboard for visual feedback. On the other hand, ESP32 only has inbuilt sensors such as Hall effect sensor and the touch sensors with support for up to 10 touch pins. Both the boards support micro USB connectivity and secure boot. Both of them also have an onboard reset button and a dedicated GPIO LED. ESP32 can be programmed using software such as Arduino IDE, Espressif IDF, MicroPython, and Lua. For Arduino Nano RP2040, programming can be done using Arduino IDE, Arduino CLI, Arduino IoT Cloud, and Arduino Web Editor. Please check out the video description to learn more about the boards from their official documentations. Keeping the hardware and software comparison aside for a moment, let us talk about the cost. This can be a critical factor in selecting the right board for your application. Arduino Nano RP2040 costs approximately $25, whereas ESP32 costs around $5. But a SparkFun ESP32 can cost up to $20. One of the best ways to know which board is right for your application is to see from the perspective of potential applications each board is suitable for. 1. Low power IoT data loggers. It requires monitoring the environment and recording data on the cloud, which can be fulfilled with ESP32 in a very cost-effective way. 2. Home automation system. For this, we need a couple of relays and Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity only. Therefore, ESP32 can do the work very efficiently. 3. Speech recognition. An inbuilt omnidirectional microphone IC with a cryptographic processor on Arduino Nano RP2040 makes it capable for securely storing keys, and a dual-core processor of great capability makes speech recognition happen in real time. 4. Wearable devices. Generally, a wearable device consists of a gyroscope and accelerometer for hand gesture movements, microphone for voice-activated commands, Bluetooth and BLE connectivity embedded inside a low battery consumption module. Arduino Nano RP2040 has all these features inbuilt. We have now understood the boards and their features in depth. Let us now look at some of the insights drawn from doing extensive research on these two boards. These points will definitely help you in choosing the right board for your application. 1. Despite a slower clock speed, Arduino Nano RP2040 has a higher processing capability due to the latest ARM architecture. 2. Arduino Nano RP2040 is a more recent development board due to which not all software has been developed to make the most out of it, and it has lesser support and more bugs than ESP32. 3. Arduino Nano RP2040 has an ESP32 onboard. Short? Yes, it is true. We have an ESP32 inside the Nina W102 U-Blocks module. 4. If power consumption is your main concern, then go for ESP32, as it has ultra-low power management features. 5. It should be noted that ESP32's inbuilt capacitive touch sensors are susceptible to electromagnetic fields, so it is not ideal for industrial environments with lot of electromagnetic interferences. 6. If there is a need for a board with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity, some GPIOs, low processor usage and is battery powered, then prefer ESP32. However, if you are looking for a board with high processing power, multiple inbuilt peripherals, higher memory and for wearable applications, then go for an Arduino Nano RP2040. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.